Hello friends, welcome to Global Tech Learn. In today's video, we will learn delete and truncate command in SQL Server. We will see how to use these two commands, what is the difference between these two, and finally how to decide which one needs to be used in what case. So let's start with the delete command. Delete command is used to delete the data from the table. This is a TML command, and usually it's been used to if we want to remove some rows from the table based on some filter. So let's see how delete command works in SQL Server. Now here we are in SQL Server. Let's see data in some table. Let's say we have a table called table 1. Let's see underlined data in the table 1. And here you can see we have 8 rows in this table. Now let's see if we want to remove row number 3, where employee ID is 1002 from this table. For that we can use delete command using delete keyword. So for that we have to write delete from. Then we have to provide the table name, that is table 1. And then we have to provide the condition which row we want to delete. So for that, where the employee ID is equals to 1002. Now let's execute this command. And here we can see one row has affected. Now let's see the data in table 1 again. And here you can see the data for employee ID 1002 has gone. So this row has been removed. Now here in SQL Server, we can use delete from table 1 to delete all the table by removing this where condition. And if we execute this command delete from table 1, let me execute this, and it should delete all the records. And here we can see it has deleted all the records. Let's verify this by select all the data from the table. And here we can see the table is blank now. But in some databases, there is a constraint that they do not allow the delete statement without any condition. It's based on the configuration in the database to make sure this command is not executed mistakenly. So to handle such situation, we can use where, let's say 1 is equals to 1. We can provide any dummy condition that should return true, and we can just add it in the delete statement to delete the data, and this should work fine. Now let's understand how delete statement works in SQL Server, and let's see what are the other features in delete statement. So first, the delete statement is part of data manipulation language, and when we run delete statement on the table, it will log the rows which will be get deleted, and then it execute the command on this and then release that log. So this is how the delete statement works. Delete statement can work with the cascade references as well. That means if we want to delete the data from the table which has reference to other table, and we want to remove the reference data from reference table as well, that we can work, that delete statement can work. So let's see this cascade reference in SQL Server. So in SQL Server, let's create two tables, that is one table for primary key and other table having a reference to the primary key. For that, let's create one table, and here let's add one field called employee ID as type integer, and this is our primary key, so let me set it as a primary key. And let's add one more field called name, that is for employee name, and let's leave it as an anchor for now. Let's save this table with name as a p table, that is for primary table. And now let's create one more table that would be a foreign table, and here again we need employee ID, that would be the foreign key, and then we need employee salary, that would be an integer data type. Now let's save this table as a table name foreign table for now, and from this table we need to establish a relationship with the primary table. So for that, let's click on relationship. If you don't know what is a primary key or foreign key or how to establish a relationship between two tables, then I have already created a dedicated video on primary key and foreign keys in the SQL Server, and I would recommend you to go through that video, and I will provide you a video link in the description. So now let's click on the add, and here we have to choose the tables for the relationship, and our primary key table is the p table. And from p table, we want to keep the relationship with the employee ID. Let's click OK. Close. Save. Yes. And here the relationship has established successfully. Now let me open new window and let me select the data from both the tables. So the first table we have is the P table, and that is blank. And then second table we have is the foreign table, where we have employee salary details. Now let's try to insert some data in both the tables. So let's insert data in P table first. So for that P table, and there we have employee ID and name and values. Let's add 1 and employee 1. Let's execute this command. And one row inserted successfully. Let's add one more record in the same table with employee ID 2 and ID 2 and let's see the data. And here we can see in primary table we have 2 records. And similarly, add some records in foreign table. So for that we have to write code, insert into F table, employee ID, then salary. So employee ID is 1 and salary, let's say it's 5000. Let's execute this command. Let's insert second record as well. So this time employee ID 2 and salary 6000. And now second table has 2 records. Now here we can see in both the tables we have employee ID 1 and 2. Now let me try to delete the data from primary table. So for that we have to write statement delete from P table, where, and let's try to delete for employee ID 1. So employee ID is equals to 1. When I try to execute this command, ideally this should throw the error because employee ID 1 from primary table has reference in foreign table. So let's execute this, and here we can see it says that it has reference, it is not able to delete the record. Now for that I have to enable the cascade. So let's go back to the foreign table. Let me refresh the list of tables, and in foreign table we need to enable the cascade. So for that over here, for delete rule, we have to enable the cascade. Let me close this, save. Okay, so it got saved successfully. Now go back to the same statement and let's try to execute this command once again. And this time here we can see one row got affected. Now let's go back to the select statement to see what data we have. And here we can see in both the tables we have one record only, that is employee ID 2. So though we tried to delete data from only from P table, that is primary table, for employee ID 1 only, but since it has reference and we have enabled the cascade, it is able to delete the data from second table as well. Thereafter, delete statement also supports the triggers. So if there is any trigger created on the table, that will be executed while deleting the record. Now before going through the remaining delete features, let's jump to the truncate statement. Truncate statement does the same job what delete statement does, that is delete all the records from the table or the partition. The major difference between these two is the way of working. The truncate, as we just learned, that delete statement delete the record from the table in row by row, but in truncate statement it does not work on the row. It does not delete the records row by row, but it deletes complete page of the table. So for that, let's go back to SQL Server, and this time let's try to truncate any table. So let me create one table, select star from table test from employees. Now we have created a table called table test. So let's see data from this table test. And here we can see we have 8 records in this table. Now let's try to truncate this table. So for that we have to apply truncate table, then we have to provide the table name, that's table test. And let's execute this command, and command executed successfully. Now let's see the data in the table once again, and this time table is blank. So as you can see, this works like same as what we can do with the delete statement to delete all the records. But then there should be a question, then why truncate table command is there since we have delete. So now let's try to understand the difference between these two. As we know, the delete statement is part of DML, but truncate is a part of DDL. So since DML try to manipulate the data and delete the data records row by row, but as the truncate is a DDL, it will work on the table level and remove the complete data page of the table. Also, as delete try to log the each record while deleting that, but truncate is not going to log the each record. Instead, it will log the complete page of the table or the table itself. That's why the truncate has lesser number of logs as compared to delete. And also, if in a table we have identity column, then delete statement is not going to affect that identity column or the sequence. However, the truncate is going to reset that as well. So for that, let's try to create one table. Let's give it name as employee ID as integer. And let's set this column as identity. So for that, we need to enable the identity from here. And let's add one more column and let's save this table. And let me give this table name as a table test 2. Now let's try to insert some data in this table. So here in table test 2, let's try to insert data from GUI window. And here let me give employee 1 as a name, employee 2, and employee 3. Now here we can see the employee ID is also created as 123 because of this column as an identity. So now let's try to delete the data from this table. So for that, let me first select all the records from table test 2, and here we can see we have 3 records. Now let's try to delete one record from this. Let's say delete from table test 2, where employee ID is equals to 3. And here we can see one record has been deleted. Now let's select data once again, and here we have 2 records only. Now let me go back to the design window. Let me close this and let me reopen this. And here you can see we have 1 and 2 records only. And let me try to insert new record and let's see what identity is going to create. So let me add this as employee 3. And here you can see the employee ID identity has been created as a 4 instead of 3. This is because 3 was already created, then we delete it from delete statement. And since delete does not affect the identity column, that's why it has already incremented to the 4. Now let me close this window. And this time, let me delete all the records from this table. And let's verify this. So this is a blank table. Now let me try to insert data once again. And as we know, the latest identity was 4. So let me add one more record. This time as a employee ID 1. And here you can see the employee ID assigned as a 5. That is as expected as per the delete statement behavior. Now let me close this. And this time, I will try to truncate the table to delete all the records from the table. Now truncate table has been truncated successfully. Let's see data. Now we don't have any data over here. Now let's try to insert data once again. And as we know, the latest identity was 5. So if I try to insert any new record, it should be assigned as a 6. But since we have truncated the table, the identity has been reset. So it should start from 1 again. So let me add employee 6. And here you can see the employee ID is 1. This is expected as the truncate statement has reset the identity for this table. Now let's move on to the next feature, that is cascades. As we seen in delete, we enable the cascade. We can delete the reference record from reference table as well. But this does not work with the truncate. If there is any reference in the table, then it will not allow to truncate the records from the table, and this truncate statement will be failed. Similarly, if there is any trigger configured on this table, the truncate is going to ignore that, because truncate does not work record by record, so it is not going to fire the any of the trigger. So as we learned so far, that delete statement works row by row. That's why it creates logs for each record. It creates a log as well. That's why the performance is comparatively less for delete statement. But when it comes to truncate, it does not create logs for each record. It creates logs only for page level or table level. And it creates very less logs compared to delete statement. That's why the performance is very fast compared to delete statement. Now the next is rollback. Once we delete any record using the delete statement, that can be rolled back as the delete statement maintains the log of the record. But as truncate does not maintain any logs or log for the record, but it maintains as the page level, that's why it does not allow to the rollback of the any record. Now with this, let's discuss how to decide when we should use delete or the truncate, as both serve the same purpose. So to understand that, we have to understand the business requirement. Usually, if we want to delete some records from the table based on the any condition, then we should proceed with delete statement. But if we want to remove all the records from the table, then we should proceed with the truncate. And again, if there are references, then we need to again go back to the delete statement. So this depends on the requirement. Usually, if we are dealing with the transactional database where we have tables with a lot of references, then we give preference to delete statement. If we are dealing with the data warehouse tables where we have dimension and tables and the references are not maintained, then we should go ahead with the truncate, as truncate has better performance compared to delete. I hope you should have learned the delete and truncate statement and what is the differences between these two and how to decide which one to use based on the business requirement.